1.
Hi, welcome to RHI, RHI's Stories of Courage, Hope, Attitude, and Inspiration, brought to you by our sponsors, Wilson Kehoe Winningham. And this is part 2. It's the rest of Carly's story. We heard her on Facebook. You can always pop onto our Facebook page and see her live interview that we did earlier. But now, Carly has such an incredible story. We want to hear the rest of it. So you only got to share a little snippet on our live part. So why don't you share a little more on what brought you to RHI in the first place?
Well, the ambulance found me on South Brookside Parkway from the unfortunate pistol accident and took me to the ICU. After the ICU got me stable, it was very much encouraged by my mother and my nurse there to come to here at RHI. And so my mother did just that, brought me here to RHI. And because of that, that's why I'm where I am today.
So why don't you explain a little bit? You got to talk about it a little bit of some of the therapy you did while you were here in the hospital. But why don't you go a little more into detail? What unit were you on while you were here?
Well, I was on unit 4. So I did physical therapy, ear and speech therapy, and then did some, was it occupational therapy? And all three of them very much paid off. Physical helped me a lot with my balance and walking, mm-hmm. and kind of learning all that over again. And then speech therapy, for a while I would be very lost with words, where I would start a sentence and then be like and kind of stop for a second till I thought about words. Now I can hold a whole sentence and make sense of it, and so speech therapy made big progress with me too. And then with occupational therapy, they are like the reason that I can work productively at my work now, is because I went through occupational therapy.
That's so awesome.
Because of our therapies, I'm wearing.
Now, you shared a little bit before the camera was rolling, even just your journey with activities of daily living, mm-hmm. and you mentioned that some of the staff by name, even, mm-hmm. if you want to give them a little shout out, who
Ms.
helped you a little
Kimmy,
bit.
Kimmy the nurse.
We like her. She's a sweetheart. What exactly did she do for you that helped you in that area?
Okay, well, when I was in my coma, she spoke to me like I could speak right back to her and knew what she was telling me. So because of that, when I went to open my eyes and really speak to her and know who she was, it was like my brain already knew, that's my best friend. Kimmy is my best friend. So guess what I did? I was attached to her. And if it wasn't for her, I probably wouldn't have learned some of the things I learned because of her. So just her friendship made a huge difference in my recovery.
And now, from what you've told me, it sounds like you're completely independent when it comes to all those types of activity, daily living, right?
Yes, and actually, if you want to know, ICU told my mother that I probably wasn't going to walk again nor take place in any of my daily activities, like using the restroom myself, showering myself. I will never stand again, walk again. And guess what? I can do all of those things now by myself. So because of RHI and because of Kimmy, that is what I can do now. And that's not what happened. So we're so excited to say I'm not stuck in a chair like that.
I'm excited for you too. Your story is so neat. Okay, so now you also mentioned somebody else who just helped you with the next steps as you were getting ready to leave the hospital. Mm-hmm. What happened there?
Well, Mr. Greg Biggs was very close with my mother, who I call Super Mom. They linked up, and after I was, you know, okay and done with RHI, but Indianapolis does not have a next step facility. So he got us hooked up with Hope NeuroCare in Michigan, and we went to Michigan, me and my mother did, and finished my recovery. And that is now why I'm at home recovering, because of Greg.
And you're not just at home recovering. Mm-hmm. You've mentioned you've got a job.
Mm-hmm.
And part of that is because of what you're currently doing in outpatient. Can you explain to our audience a little bit what you're doing over at our NBIC facility?
Mm-hmm. Well, we have what they call voc rehab, and they have been such a big help with me getting a new job and like working for the first time about a year and a half after the accident. So it was very fresh getting a new job, not working for a good year and a half. They helped me to one, get the job, prepared me to get the job. I now also have a job coach that voc rehab set me up with and worked through. Also, what else did voc rehab do? Well, they check in with me constantly. I mean, even though I'm still working, like they'll make sure that I am successfully working for at least a good 120 days. So, I mean, when they helped you, it's before your employment, right when you start your employment, and after your employment.
That's great. So it's not like you're just like pushed into a job and then left to figure it all out yourself.
No, basically, if there's anything I need, those are the people to go through, and they've made my experience just amazing.
You also mentioned something else. I mean, you mentioned that you're doing speech therapy over mm-hmm. at NBIC right now. Mm-hmm. And then that you're currently, I mean, one of the reasons why we want to get this video done is because you have an appointment in a few minutes. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about that. I don't want to.
So I'm back in speech therapy by voc rehab's recommendation, meaning that they basically felt that I could benefit from speech therapy. So they wrote me an order for speech therapy, and I'm getting back into that over there. And then with BICS, that is I call it my brain class. That is what I call it. And it has taught me so many great coping skills. Just things that I use daily, like always encourage yourself or compliment yourself for the small things that you accomplish. Don't just blow those off. If it's small, it's still super big. You can tell yourself that it is okay. And BICS has also taught me to just, you know, positively talk to yourself, keep your negative talking out your head, and it can help. So just with the BICS program has helped me like stay a positive person, but still with my injury, and I just love it. It just makes me so happy. I like it.
That's awesome. One of the neat things that we love about the BICS program is that is something that stemmed out of some research that we were originally doing here, mm-hmm. and it is now a program that other hospitals have adopted around the world. So it's pretty cool. Can you just real quick, before we wrap up the video, explain to our audience how you are doing your BICS today?
Well, I do it either, it can be on your phone or tablet, so I can do it basically wherever I'm at, as long as I have internet access. And then on the screen, I will see all of our other friends, plus our director, which is Claire. And it is something I love to go to every Wednesday. You would think it's like a class, like you're really learning something, but it's a class that has even made this part of my recovery more successful, because she has taught me how to just keep moving forward positively, and I love it.
Well, thank you so much for coming in. And I'm telling you, we could probably keep Carly here for another hour to hear more of her story. She's just such a beautiful lady, and has just worked so hard and come a long way since your injury. We're just really proud of you, Carly.
Thank you.
I have to say that the BICS program, some of these things that you heard Carly talk about are a result of some of the sponsors and donors mm-hmm. who have provided money for the research to happen, for people to have scholarship to even attend BICS. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much to all our donors. If you're interested in being a part of this and a part of changing lives, go ahead and click on the link that's a part of this video, and you can and help change other people's lives. Thank you so much for joining us today. Mm-hmm.